Hey everybody, it's Chainsaw Reacts. This is my non-spoiler review for Aquaman. There is so many things I want to talk about, but I can't because this is a non-spoiler review. So I'm going to try my very best to not dive into too many things because I'm afraid I'm going to get into spoilers because there's so much shit that happens in this movie because the movie was already great, and that's a spoiler right there. I freaking love this movie. This movie was already great. Then the third act happened, and then it fucking went crazy. Holy shit. Now, this was brought up during the marketing of Aquaman before it started releasing overseas and everything like that, and then we started hearing feedback, was the trailers were coming out awesome. Then they put out that 5-minute extended look, which I checked out, and it was freaking great. But the question was brought up, are they showing too much? Are they revealing too much? And I can tell you, because I just watched the film, no. Now, they revealed some really cool parts, and maybe they should have maybe not revealed some, but there are a lot of great moments that they have not shown in the trailers that they're hiding, and a round of applause, because holy shit, they could have showed us a lot more, and there are some great things they've kept hidden. There's just been great character moments, some great, like, epic, holy shit moments that they're hiding, and I have to give them a round of applause for keeping that stuff hidden, because it makes me watching the film much more enjoyable because I had no idea that this was happening. I had no idea this was coming. There's some great, great moments. I gotta start off with saying this before we get into the cast and the characters and all that kind of stuff and, you know, everything. James Wan, the director, a round of applause. This man delivered, I think, probably the best thing he could have done in terms of Aquaman. Because, let's be honest, Justice League was not received well. When I first saw the film, I really enjoyed it. Then started hearing the backlash, and I started to rewatch the film again and realize, okay, I was praising this film too much. But Justice League was the last film that was not received well. My audience that I saw the film with at like 8:25 tonight was pretty packed. Some great responses from people. It got a great response, and that shows that they did the marketing well, because now people are in the seats. Because I was afraid I was going to walk into a half-empty theater, and it was the majority of it was full. And James Wan delivered a phenomenal film here. I just can't not praise him enough, because he was able to figure out the underwater techniques to make it believable. Because, yes, there's been underwater stuff in the past, but man, they figured out a really cool way to make it work. Now, some of the audio in terms of character dialogue can be kind of hard to hear at times, but when you get accustomed to this kind of effect when people are talking underwater, and not the Justice League way where they make an air bubble, that's not that happens a little bit, but that's not what they do when they're talking underwater. It sounds a little jarring at first, but then you get accustomed to it, and it's pretty awesome, and it just becomes a normal thing you're used to in the movie once it's already done. The CG is phenomenal, and James Wan, I gotta give a round of applause to him for that too. I mean, I know he didn't personally work on the CG himself, but he was able to craft this film using some practical stuff, but mostly CG, and the CG looked great. There was no like moments where I'm like, and that CG's kind of wonky. It was freaking awesome. Just whatever he asked, whatever James Wan wants to do the sequel, give it to him, Warner Brothers. Give it to him, because he delivered on this fucking movie. Let's jump off into some of the characters. I mean, I didn't mean to talk for, like, in 4 minutes in, we haven't gotten to the fucking characters, but there's a lot to talk about here. But, like I said, no spoilers. Jason Momoa, Amber Heard, Aquaman, and Mera. Phenomenal. Love their chemistry. There were some moments where there was, like, some character moments I'm like, okay, I can see where that's happening. What I like is that, of course, we know Mera and Aquaman are together in the comics. That is a thing. In this movie, they start to build to that. And there are some moments that maybe they could have extended on, maybe some moments they could have, you know, fleshed it out more. But the way the story is structured, there's not a lot of downtime, in a sense, to really expand a lot on this. Because what I love about it is that Jason Momoa's Aquaman, of course, gets the main portion of the film. It's his film, of course, and it's his story. Mera gets a good portion. Amber Heard does a great job as the character, and just Momoa's Aquaman is awesome. I think he's 20 times better than he was in Justice League in this movie. He's way better in this movie than he was in Justice League. If you liked his character, if you tolerated him in Justice League, I think you're going to like him in this movie. And if you loved him in Justice League, you're going to love him even more in this movie. And of course, you see the suit there with the poster. Phenomenal. There were some jokey parts. Some jokes from him and Amber Heard landed, others not so much with my audience. For me, I felt the majority of the humor in terms of Jason Momoa's Aquaman, Amber Heard as Amara, worked pretty well, and I love their chemistry, like I said, and I like that they built this story, which I won't reveal too much. I mean, they hint at it and stuff in the trailers, but it makes sense, and we kind of see Mara's conflict with her and King Orm and her and Arthur, Aquaman, so I like how they played on that. There were some great character moments with these characters. There could have been some more, but with the way the film is structured, which I'll get into more in a second, I understood why they made the decision to let some moments, you know, maybe not extend too much and let other things happen that needed to happen in order for the film to get to the third act, which is fucking bonkers. Let's talk about the two villains. King Orm and, of course, Black Manta. Patrick Wilson is King Orm, and I'm not even going to try to pronounce the actor's name who plays Black Manta, but holy crap. Round of applause to both of them, really. So, we heard that King Orm was the main villain, and he is. Black Manta is a secondary villain, and my fear was, oh crap, Black Manta's going to get shorthanded. I mean, maybe they should have held him off entirely till the sequel, but the way they set up Black Manta's character, holy Jesus. Now, I've been seeing some people commenting online. I'm not going to get into specifics because, you know, they were pointing out specifics of why they don't like him in the film. Some of the criticism about Black Manta and his purpose and what he's doing in this movie, I disagree with people that are saying, what's the point of having Black Manta? They set it up pretty great in the opening of this movie in terms of Black Manta's role and how they trickle him in throughout the film. Yes, he's a secondary villain, but damn, is he effective in my personal opinion. So that's all needed, and damn, the suit looks fucking great. Patrick Wilson as King Orm, he delivers. You know, this character has been done in the comics many different times. Of course, we have the one of the recent animated films, Justice League: Throne of Atlantis, which is of course an adaptation from the comics, and was pretty well done. And they handled King Orm pretty well in that. But I think Patrick Wilson nails King Orm in this movie. And what I love, and this was a fear of mine, and James Wan squashed that pretty early on, was my fear was King Orm was going to be a one-note type villain, even though that's not him in the comics. Now, sometimes he's been kind of one-notish, but they've expanded on more of his idealism and his way of thinking and why he does certain things. They gave Patrick Wilson as King Orm enough to do, enough screen time and enough story in his character for me to really believe and understand why he thinks the way he does and why he's so against Arthur for a couple different reasons and why he's against land, why he's against, like, you know, land people, as you know, they're kind of phrased, you know, he's against that whole idea. It's amazing, and I'm so glad, because there was an interview where Patrick Wilson was saying that he wanted to just follow James Wan along whatever journey James Wan, because, you know, James Wan, of course, does the Conjuring films. Patrick Wilson wants to be on the journey with James Wan in terms of whatever he does next, and I'm so glad that James Wan brought him on board, because Patrick Wilson knocked it out of the park, and the actor who played Black Manta as well. A lot of great moments. If you are afraid that King Orm and Black Manta are just going to be one-note villains that are just kind of bland and there's no real purpose and they're just there for Aquaman to fight, don't worry. There's a lot of great moments to make these characters hateable or lovable, depending on how you see it, but they're great villains. They really, really are. Now, there's, of course, other characters in the film, like, of course, Aquaman's father. Of course, we have Nicole Kidman as Atlanta. I'm trying to remember her name. Very sorry about that. That's the one name I've always seemed to forget. But Nicole Kidman as Arthur's mother, not father. Dolph Lundgren is in this movie, which I really like that. I mean, and then, of course, we have Willem Dafoe as Vulko. There are some great moments in this movie with all of the characters I listed there. I mean, Atlanta, blah. it's almost midnight. I'm tired. It is midnight, actually. I love Nicole Kidman's character. I'm not going to go into too much detail, but I really like what they did with her character. And Arthur's father, I thought he would have had more screen time, but he didn't. But it is what it is. But his role in the film I think served its purpose, and it was used to its effect. And Dolph Lundgren, I mean, look, he's made some pretty crappy decisions in terms of some films he's done over the years, but I think this was a pretty good decision because he did a great job in this role. And like I said before, the CG is just freaking great. Trust me, once you see this movie, it's going to blow your mind in terms of what they did with the underwater stuff. What else? Okay, so I do have one like real criticism, and it's nothing story-wise. I think the story was pretty well done. The structure-wise, I think it was great. You know, after writing my Star Wars fan film, it made me start to think about movies and how scripts are written, because of course, script to screen is obviously can be interpreted differently. So I'm not sure if this is a script issue or if this was a James Wan decision that I kind of think I wish he would have made a change. But there are certain There's a certain thing that happens right as an action beat starts. I'm not going to say what it is because I guess you could say it's a spoiler and it might, you know, make you guys look out for it. But there's a certain thing that happens right as an action scene starts. And it happens multiple times in a row. And I kind of see it coming. And it kind of bothered me because I'm like, I wish I didn't expect that to happen. Like, of course, there should be action. There's a lot of action scenes in this movie. And I was like, okay, there's a lot of action scenes because it kept, like, action scene again. Okay, a couple minutes. Action scene. I'm like, okay, when is the CG going to, like, kind of, like, the CG just kept up. $200 million. It was totally worth it. But there's a certain thing that happens throughout a couple of the action beats in a row where right as an action scene is about to start, something happens, and then it happens again, and then again, the same thing. I really wish they would have made a change. I really wish they would have did something different to kind of break up the same thing starting an action scene. But that's my only real huge complaint. The film delivers. I mean, it's got some emotional moments. It's got some crazy action. The third act, I swear, the third act, you've seen bits and pieces in the trailer, but they hit a lot of the third act from marketing, and I'm so glad they did, because man, if they would have revealed a lot of the, because they could have easily shown a lot of the third act in this movie, and they don't from the trailers that I've seen, they don't, and I hope they keep it that way, because I want people just to go see it, because man, it is insanity, it really is. But like I said, great character moments with a lot of the characters, and some great flashbacks showcasing Aquaman's Arthur Curry's growing up and what he experienced. I guess you could say this is a 100% origin film, kind of tied in with the current storyline, which is not an origin because, I mean, I guess you could say origin in the sense of him going to Atlantis, but it's not like this is his first time finding out he can swim underwater and he can talk to fish and all that. It's not that. They do showcase some of that in terms of flashbacks, which I enjoy because I feel like they needed to do that because Aquaman, of course, was introduced officially for the first time in Justice League cameo and BVS. So it makes sense for them to showcase. But James Wan, I think, did a great job in terms of getting the script to where we are focusing on the current story, which, of course, after Justice League, after that event, and we are showing flashbacks to kind of, you know, set up, and this is kind of what he was doing when he was younger, when he got a little bit older. It's great. It really is. And where this film ends, of course, once again, no spoilers, I'm really excited to see where we go from here. And I really hope James Wan, I mean, they've already been, there's already been talks at Warner Bros. That they're going to start working on a sequel. My guess is after the opening, I'm guessing, because they're already tracking this, but things going to make over $100 million, blah, opening weekend here in the U.S. And it's already made over $260 million worldwide. And that number is just going to go up, up, and up. So my guess is they're going to sign on James Wan pretty quick for the sequel. If he wants to do it, if he doesn't, that's okay. But wow, this thing delivers. And I'm excited to see what happens next. And my heater just turned on. I don't know if you guys can't hear that. Yeah, then okay, good. But I can hear it. This was great. This is great. I can't wait to see it again. I don't know if I'm going to go see it again in the theater because I need to go see a bunch of other films that I've missed. But man, if you guys are on the fence about Aquaman and you're still here watching the review at this point, go see it. Give it a shot. It is great. It really is. Sure, some people have some issues with some of the story and some say it's kind of muddy. It's too long. I think the length is pretty good because it kept me engaged. There was not a point in the movie I'm like, eh, it's boring. I was never bored watching this movie. I was always intrigued, always engaged, and they used this film to tell the backstory of Arthur Curry and being raised, the current storyline with King Orm and what's going on there and Black Manta and all that kind of stuff. And then you get to see some of the history of Atlantis, and it's just, it's awesome. It's freaking great what they do with this movie. A lot of mythology, a lot of setup. And it really makes you go, what are they going to do with the sequel? You have some ideas after watching the movie what they could do in the sequel, but man, they can go anywhere in the sequel, and I'm excited for it. So there you have it. That's my non-spoiler review for Aquaman. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know in the comment section below, blah, if you've already seen the film, and what'd you think about it? Non-spoilers, please do not spoil. And if you haven't seen the film, are you guys excited? Whatever thoughts you have about the film or what you're hoping to see in the film if you're going to go see it, let me know in the comment section below, guys. I will talk to you guys soon. Peace out.